Nice day, but windy.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Summer. Only got the two duvets on.
Better than it was yesterday.
Yeah, true. True. It's a bit windy though today.
Yeah.
So, you know, buffeting could be an issue on the route and a big problem for the cameraman, which is obviously me again. I have volunteered for filming duty. We are recording.
Right, well, I did this back in 73 with my dad. Just me and my dad and my mother at the Crag, and it was top of the grade for us then. No, it wasn't actually. It wasn't top of the grade because we'd done Holocaust before that.
we'll just see what that is.
Well, I'm pumped warming up.
So 50 years ago yesterday.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And we're here again today.
Absolutely.
For the big ascent.
The big ascent, yeah. And
joined by Jim the dog.
Yeah. Mr. Cooksey must be around. So yesterday was a shocking day, and I like to do it exactly on the day, but it was just raining for 2 days previously. And all day yesterday, and it stopped in the evening. And at least it's dry now, but it's got this very uncomfortable buffety wind. And on something like Pink Panther, which is quite delicate in places and the protections are not brilliant, a buffeting wind is what you don't want. So we'll just have to see. It'll all be very exciting.
Describe some of the route for us.
It's a diagonal climb up a really rough wall in this part of the Crag, as you can see in the sunshine there, and it takes a sort of vague scoop diagonally from bottom left to top right, with the crux probably being a bulge about three quarters height on the wall. But it's must be 30 years since I've done it. I was actually going to do it last year, but I'd uncoiled the ropes at the bottom of the Crag, and this bloke comes to the bottom of the route, and I looked at him, I said, "Are you Steve McClure?" And he said, "Yeah." I said, "Oh, Rob Matheson, pleased to meet you." So we had a great conversation after that. But the bottom line of the story is that I let Steve McClure do it with his daughter instead of doing it. So I haven't got any sort of recollection of it at all, except the truncated spike, which is a feature of the route. Back in the day, I put a sling on it and weighed it down with a peg hammer so it wouldn't come off. But I haven't got that today, so we'll see how it goes. Okie dokie.
All right.
Yep. Here we go. 50 years on.
Terrible.
I remember nothing about it whatsoever. Not so bad so far. This looks a bit tricksome. Right, I'm gonna I'm going to put a sling on here. Oh, everything, I'm going to do everything in blue until, yeah, I think so. I'll stand on it there so it won't come off. I'll get something in here. That'll be a bit, hopefully a bit better. Blue again, mate. I might put one of these newfangled friend doodads in here. Might as well. I brought them. The rock's fantastic. It's really, really rough. I don't trust them. Okie dokie. I think I go across here. Right, I'll put one in here. Might like the can't quite see that yet. All right, blue again. Shoddy clip. I'll just have a look at that one, I'll step up. Yeah, I think that's good. It's knowing where to go here. Okay. Not a lot there. Buffety wind. Oh, I think I can get one in here, an RP. That's not good. Just that wind's just a little bit disconcerting. Right, I think I've got to move horizontally here. I'm not sure whether to go up or across low. Can't see with the sun. Get one in here, mate. Blue again. The truncated spike. Yay! Right, red. Oh, I think there's a little RP in here. And that spike should hold it down there. Right, originally I think I went across here. A desperate move. But most people seem to go straight up now. That's pretty good. Right. That seems pretty hard for the grid. You can see why a lot of E2 leaders have difficulty there. I mean, that's not well protected, is it? Okay. Nice. Nice. That's what I call a spike. Red. Okay, mate. I originally traversed into the corner, but it's finer climbing out here. Is that another spike? Well. Two spikes. Traditional. traditional. Oh yes. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Just put a runner on here, mate. Thought I might go around here.
So how did you find that this time, 50 years later?
All right, actually, it was really positive, with the odd delicate move, balancing move in places, but the rock's fantastic.
It's good quality.
But the protection's not brilliant for the grade. Unless you're comfortable.
Did it feel bold on the crux?
Yeah, it did feel quite bold on the crux, because I had a little RP and the I think the sling fell off.
The sling did fall off.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
Right.
But you'd done the crux.
Oh, well, that's the main thing. I've done the crux. Thank the Lord. Yeah, that crux is going straight over the bulge. Is probably pushing E3, isn't it?
Yeah.
Feeling.
So. Yeah.
Especially if you haven't got great protection in.
Yeah. Well, there isn't anything else, though, is there?
Possibly, if you look around. Yeah. You look around. Oh, and you could have put cams in, I think.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Might hold the sling on as well.
Yeah, you could. I'm sure you could. You could. But if you're climbing E2, that's top end E2.
Definitely.
No doubt about it.
Yeah.
I'm really pleased in answer to your question. How I feel? I feel good. I feel pleased.
You remember what it felt like when you were 23?
I can't actually remember. I think I found it all right. I mean, I was climbing probably E4 at that time. So I think I originally graded it E3 6A.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, originally, which is hell of a grade back in those days.
Mm.
So I must have found it quite difficult.
Climbing in EBs.
Climbing in EBs. Yeah, EBs and no cams.
No RPs.
And no RPs. But the placements wouldn't have been worn out.
No. Definitely had slings, though.
I've definitely had slings, and I definitely had a peg hammer to weigh the sling on the truncated spike. Because
yeah.
I traversed low on the first ascent into the corner, which is a really hard move, actually, really hard. That's what I gave 6A to.
Yeah.
But going straight up feels bolder, probably.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is bolder because you're going above it.
Behind,
yeah, you're not going sideways from it. Yeah, brilliant.
I think we did it low when we first did it.
Yeah.
And we weighted that sling down with a load of hexes, I remember that.
Right.
Just to keep it on.
The original heavy hexes.
Yeah.
Great stuff. And how do you find it today?
Hard. I was going to say easy, but it wasn't.
It was. No, there was a few moves where you got to move up and there's no handholds.
No.
And
quite balancing.
Yeah, balancing. You got to balance up. You're not quite sure where to traverse and where to balance
obvious.
Up. Yeah.
Definitely not obvious.
Yeah, technically, really good.
Yeah. Classic.
Yeah. Pleased with that.